was panic among Bali Regional Referral Hospital administrators and staff as the State House Health Monitoring Unit ordered the arrest of 5 medics on allegation of extortion. They were yesterday picked from the hospital following undercover investigations. The suspects were detained at Mbale Police Station.
Why don't you inscribe your name to the clinic? All nurses, beginning to
how many days can you do?
By Friday. By Friday. We want to inscribe names like the doctor,
Dr. Brian Arinaitre, the assistant director of the State House Health Monitoring Unit, confirmed the arrests. Investigations revealed that some patients in the hospital had resorted to getting services at nearby clinics due to the high level of extortion at the facility. Patients are also encouraged to go to the surrounding clinics instead of getting free services at the hospital. Bali City RRCC Asumin Nasike confirmed these discoveries and put new measures in place to curb these vice.
We are going to clean up this hospital. Anyone malingering around within Bali Main, if you don't have a patient, if you are not sick, why are you within here?
Stephen Obo, the director of Mbale Regional Referral Hospital, regretted the incident, highlighting efforts by administration to fight the vice. Obo also highlighted the financial burden the facility is grappling with while offering health services to the community.
Well, I can also say our budget is definitely not sufficient. I was just discussing with people. I think Dr. Namumba's budget has been coming down. I think from this year it's 120, not so. Has come down over time.
Following the announcement by Leader of Opposition Joel Senyonyi to boycott the anticipated regional parliamentary outreaches organized by Parliament, a section of legislators from the Northern Region have lashed out at him, accusing him of sidelining the region. Nsamba Patrick, MP for Kasanda North, during yesterday's plenary sessions, asked parliamentary leadership to clear the matter.
A proper communication needs to come to this House, so that the country knows the reasons why and the advantages. Everything needs to be communicated.
The Deputy Speaker, Thomas Tayebwa, cautioned legislators against loose utterances, saying that leadership had agreed with the Clerk to Parliament to present a document elaborating the plans.
When we are making statements, we should be very cautious. For example, I don't think we are spending 5 billion. For the sitting, for the proposed sitting. Okay? I read, is it 5 billion per day? So 20 billion, and now the public is saying that you stop those sittings so that we pay in terms.
Senyonyi announced the boycott on Tuesday, saying that he wasn't consulted on Parliament having regional sittings, implying that the organizers have hidden agendas. Officials of the Uganda Bureau of Statistics have confirmed that payment for the 1,519 and 1,371 census enumerators and supervisors respectively is still pending due to various reasons. According to UBOS, they paid 98.7% of the workforce and promised to pay the rest before the end of this month. This communication comes at a time when various groups have come out in protest over non-payment by the Bureau, yet they delivered their mandate.
1,000 guides contributing to 97.1% have already been paid their entitlements, and only 3,240 are yet to be settled.
Speaking to journalists at the media center, Okoth said that UBOS have given 328 billion shillings for the census and that it has been put to rightful use.
A total of 98.7% enumerators and their supervisors have been settled.